Hey, mate, what were your opinions of the Do Better report and the Collingwood thing?
I haven't read the report, so I don't know, yeah.
Okay.
But the part where you said, oh, we're proud or something, yeah. Yeah, that wasn't a good look, yeah.
In that convo, it was... It just provided an opportunity to get Derek's opinion to try and understand the challenge that the nation has around straightening up the attitudes towards Indigenous people. It wasn't communicated effectively, but what the club wanted to try and get across through the media was that it was that it felt like it was doing the right thing, that it was taking the right
steps. Taking the right steps, yeah.
But you don't do badly for a long time and then go, oh, give us some credit for doing, for wanting to do better now. Yeah. So that's probably where we got it wrong.
Yeah.
Having an elder statesman who is an Indigenous man in the camp is opportune for me because I'm still trying to learn about where the steps forward are to work through this challenge that the nation has. And clearly Collingwood have put themselves at the front of that to be better and do better. It's really hard to know how to communicate it because in the end, what I think what our job is as a white privileged male is actually not to talk about it, it's actually just to listen.
Yeah, listen, well, that's it. That's a problem.
I didn't learn that until Haricha Lumumba forced it.
Yeah.
And that's not even having a conversation with him, but forced it from there until I was prepared to sit in it long enough to realise that, hey, it's not our story here.
When you're talking about Aboriginal issues, who are the expert matters? People. As the Aboriginal person. So that's why you're saying, like, you gotta listen. So, you know, I've been in that situation where there's an organisation, right? They're running Aboriginal programs, but they're doing it wrong. And then when I'm going to tell them and talking to CEO, saying, no, you gotta do this, you know, this is how you should be doing it. You gotta listen to what I'm telling you because otherwise you're gonna get a bad reputation out of the community.
Yeah.
And if you don't listen, then you got no chance.
Yeah.
You know, you're not gonna survive or you're gonna get it wrong. And that's exactly what happens. There's a lot of organisations, they don't listen to the experts.
When I played, I was a copper just about every week. But, you know, the AFL was put a policy in place in the early 90s about the racism at the clubs. It was slowly getting there, but a long way to go.
I think there's 18 or 19 recommendations that have come out of that report. And, like, it's about reinforcing the rap, different changes to structure, what the education's going to be, staffing ratios, like all of that, all of that stuff has come out of it.
One of the things I would recommend is why haven't they got an Aboriginal past player on the board?
Yeah.
You know, you need an average footballer that knows ins and out on the footy field.
Just lived it.
Yeah. Nathan wants to learn and know about the First Nations people, cultures and history. So, yeah, I think he's on the right path.
There was some stuff that came out in Goodsy's Australian Dream. We sat down as a group and, like, as a club and watched all of that. There was blokes that came out of that saying, I never knew that. I never knew that the slavery, and there was graphic images in that.
Well, even you got the Prime Minister saying there was no, you know, there was no slavery in Australia. Well, he's lying, you know.
And that's just more of the same, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, mate, talking about mistakes, I had a 2017 press conference when H came out. He brought a documentary out. And they were asking about the name.
Yeah, I heard him say,
And had I heard it? So the question was around that. And because I got defensive about that, I lost sight of the bigger picture, which is exactly what I should be as a leader. I should be thinking about the bigger picture. When I look back at that, I thought, that looks terrible. Sport is often seen as a window to social change, and listening and learning and trying to understand is the only way to begin